fireworks are a fascinating controlled explosive which is used to put on spectacular light shows on various holidays worldwide, including for the 4th of July, which is today for my American viewers. Happy 4th of July, by the way. These fireworks, while spectacular, would not have been possible without the extraction of various elements in numerous mining operations. And I do not simply mean the potassium nitrate, sulfur, and carbon through charcoal, which are all components used to form gunpowder. The fireworks shot into the sky on various holidays have a wide range of colors, essentially filling every spot of the rainbow. This video will discuss the exact chemical elements used to cause fireworks to turn various colors as well as different effects produced. Before I go into the details, I want to explain why various elements burn as differing colors. Put simply, the chemical makeup and burn temperatures determine the color a compound will burn as. This is made possible by the emission spectra of the flame. Simply put, when an atom is subjected to heat, the heat will excite the electrons, sometimes causing them to jump to a higher orbit. The resulting orbit is not as stable, so eventually the electron jumps back to its original position, losing energy in the form of a photon in doing so. The color of the light depends on the total energy released, which is determined by both the distance the electron traveled, which varies between each element, and the temperature it was excited to. With this being said, here are the crucial elements for each major color. Red fireworks generally receive their color due to concentrations of the element strontium, although sometimes it can also be owed to the element lithium. Reddish-purple fireworks owe their coloration to the element rubidium. Pink fireworks owe their color to the element lithium. Orange fireworks owe their color due to either the combination of strontium and sodium, or just calcium. Yellow fireworks are colored by the presence of sodium, but sometimes also carbon and iron. Green fireworks owe their color to an element I used to mine a decent amount of, barium. Blue fireworks owe their coloration to the element copper. Since purple is often thought of as a combination of red and blue colors, it should not come as a surprise that purple fireworks utilize both strontium and copper. White fireworks generally use magnesium, but sometimes aluminum. Gray fireworks use a combination of magnesium, titanium, and zirconium. As for fireworks which purposely produce a high amount of smoke, this is largely achieved due to the inclusion of the element zinc. The effect of sparks and fireworks are achieved through the element iron, and glittering effects are achieved through including the element antimony. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron and co for supporting this channel.